Reclaiming the Republican stage, revelling in the spotlight.
I love you too.
Donald Trump invited back to a state he narrowly won in 2020, headlining North Carolina's GOP convention with a blistering assault on his successor.
As we gather tonight, our country is being destroyed before our very own eyes.
The former president still fuming over his election loss 7 months on.
What happened to this country in that last election was a disgrace.
Releasing a YouTube video hours earlier, boldly claiming,
we're going to take back the Senate, take back the House, we're going to take back the White House, and sooner than you think.
Ousted at the height of the pandemic, Trump's now demanding China pay reparations for the damage caused by COVID-19.
We should all declare within one unified voice that China must pay. They must pay.
Calling for 100% tariffs on all Chinese-made goods into America. It was a roll call of enemies, singling out Dr. Anthony Fauci.
Not a great doctor, but he's a hell of a promoter.
And Mark Zuckerberg, whose platform Facebook has now banned him until 2023.
He used to come to the White House. He'd call, oh, could I have dinner with you, sir? He said, you're number one on Facebook.
They may allow me back in 2 years. We got to stop that. We can't let it happen. So unfair.
Even without a social media megaphone, Trump remains the frontrunner for the party's presidential nomination in 2024. Republicans who have spoken out against him have been punished, proving the remarkable hold he still has over the GOP.
I am not the one trying to undermine American democracy. I'm the one that's trying to save it.
In the United States, Ashley Mullaney, 7 News.